This is great. All you folks come and honor my best friend, Leslie Wellsworth, a very unique man. You asshole, there's no such thing as very unique. You are either unique or you're not unique, you wanker. Oh, I'm sorry, Les. I'm sorry. So here is a man. Here's a man that is very special. Years ago, I had a member when I ran the club at Green Hill in Worcester, Mass. We used to call him Fluffy. He cheated like a son of a gun. He was terrible. And we caught him stealing some shirts and stuffing them down his pant. And we said to him, Joe, you can't do that. He said, I have to, it's my life, whatever. So Debbie and I went to his funeral, and the priest didn't know much about his background. So he said, here is Joe laying here. He's touched us in one way or another, meaning put things in his pocket. Les was the dearest friend I ever had, and we had so many good times together. We went to New Zealand and Australia, and we were in a very great golf course called Cowrie Cliffs. He had this jacket, it was a killer jacket, it was kind of checked. He had his smart pants on and stuff. So we went to this was $1,200 a night, guys. So we went for the cocktail hour, and here's Les. And he is holding court, shall we say, with some nice people from Holland. And all of a sudden, his little bag started emitting some methane gas, and you heard, and without blinking an eye, he said, I have a medical problem, as you might well guess. So he could get away with murder. He was a real, true rascal. And that's why you like him. Anyone that didn't know Les didn't know a rascal. He was registered. And so, in ending, I can't end because I have to read two messages, because he was fortunate enough to have so many friends, and he shared them with me. His dear sister Jean and his dear sister Beryl. So I will read this to you. From Jean, my darling Les, as an older sister, I had the privilege of taking care of the little things whilst, that is really English, you were growing up.
Wild.
We had a wonderful life together, you visiting Australia, lunches at Doyle's, that is a great restaurant, and at the Cheryl with Beryl, oh, that rhymes, and Bobby, family and friends, and Carol and Margaret. Our many travels around the world, ups and downs, we shared them together. Our last trip, which Les really looked forward to, was last year. They did the Northern Territory on a train. It was called the Ghan and the Barbarossa Valley and Kangaroo Island. My annual visits to Palm Beach, which I toiled in your frame shop, paid zero. I will never forget the golfing days at the par three with the boys and in Australia at the coast with Dennis. Dennis was his best friend, and they talked so much about each other. They loved each other for 40 years. I lost count of the number of balls I found for you, and I lost count of all the damn balls he lost. Remember Borat? Leslie was very nice, and as a golfer, not so nice. He had a bond, you'll never be broken, and I miss you terribly and love you always. Now this is from his sister Beryl. My darling Leslie, I love you so much and will miss you forever. We will always be with you and our family. We have had so many fun, great times at the Sheraton, which we went to, and I think you went to. It was a great buffet, and I never met a buffet I didn't like. And Luis's Chinese restaurant, where we had prawn cutlets. I was so thrilled when you came home for my birthday, this is Sister Beryl, and lovely to be with you. You have had a successful business life, and we are so proud of you. I am proud to be your older sister. Everything you met, we're better off by knowing you and having a friend like you. I will always love you. And lastly, I would like to say that I feel very lucky because Les introduced me to all his friends who now I consider my friends. Thank you.